Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Strong Math. Today in this video we will discuss about basic set theory. The concept of set serves as fundamental part of the present day mathematics. Today this concept is being used in almost every branch of mathematics. Sets are used to define the concepts of relations as well as functions. The study of geometry, sequence, probability, statistics, etc. requires the knowledge of sets. So set is very important topic of our mathematics. The theory of sets were developed by German mathematician George Cantor. He was performing some problems related to trigonometric series, and at that time he encountered sets. In this video we will discuss about some basic definitions and operations involving set. So keep watching this video till the end. So the definition of set is: a collection of objects or elements are said to form a set if the collection is well defined. We will explain what is the meaning of well defined collection. All the objects are distinct, that is, in that collection the elements will be different. The objects are independent of order. That is, objects must not satisfy the order of their occurrence. Let's explain what is the meaning of well-defined collection. Look, I have given 5 examples. Number 1, all the good students of your class. Now, think about the word good. Good student. Whom we will say good students? Can we measure who are good and who are bad? So this collection is not well defined. This is not well defined. Why? We can't measure the students who are good and who are bad. So next, moving on. Number 2. All the students who have scored 80% and above in maths. So here we can say that this collection is well defined. Why? We can easily find out who have scored 80% or above in maths. So we can collect the informations and set a collection which is well defined. Now all the good actors of Bollywood, now you can easily understand, these can't make a well defined collection. Number 4, all the batsmen of Indian cricket team. So here specifically we can understand which kind of collections to be formed. Here we collect the name of the batsman of Indian cricket team. So specifically we can find out a collection which is well defined. Number 5, all the beautiful ladies in our country. So who are beautiful and who are not, we can't measure. So hence this is not a well defined collection. So basically, to be a well-defined collection, we have to mention the collection properly. That is, we have to give a perfect and measurable information to be that collection well-defined. So in the given definition of set, look, a collection of objects or elements are said to form a set if the collection is well defined. So the first criteria to form a set, the collection must be well defined. I hope you have already understood the meaning of well defined. Next, in the second criteria, all the objects, that is all the objects or elements of that collection must be distinct. that is must be different. And number three, the objects are independent of order, that is, it is not necessary for the elements or objects in that collection to maintain the ascending order or descending order. They are independent of order. So if these three criteria are satisfied, then the collection is called set. Representations of set. At first, we will discuss some basic notations. The sets are represented by capital letters like A, B, C, X, Y, etc. The elements of a set are denoted by small letters like small a, small b, small c, d, etc. Number 3, if S be a set and A be an object, then either this object A is an element of S, then we write A belongs to S. This symbol is known as belongs to. Or A is not an element of the set S, then we write A does not belongs to S. This is the symbol which is known as does not belongs to. Let's discuss the methods of representation of set. Sets are generally represented in two forms. Number one, roster form or tabulation form. And number two, set builder form or property form. In roster form, all the elements of a set are listed. The elements are being separated by using comma and are enclosed with the second bracket. For example, the set of all prime natural numbers less than 20 is described in roster form as in second brackets. You can see which is highlighted in the yellow color 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17 and 19. They are all prime numbers which are less than 20 and they are separated by using the comma. So in roster form representation, we have to write the exact elements in details by using comma and second bracket. Another one, the set of all vowels in the English alphabet is in second brackets A, E, I, O, U. You know the vowels are A, E, I, O and U. We write to represent this set, that is a set of vowels in the English alphabet, in second brackets and they are separated by using a comma. Number two, set builder form. In the set builder form, all the elements of a set possesses a single common property which is not possessed by any element outside the set. That is, the element which belongs to the same set possesses a common property. For example, in the set second bracket 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, you can see that all the elements possess a common property, which is each of the elements is a prime natural numbers and no other numbers possesses this property. Suppose we denote this set as capital A. Then we can write A equals to in brackets X such that X less equals to 20 because we choose the elements which are less equals to 20 and X is prime number and X belongs to the set of naturals N. So in this property or in this method of representation, we have to write that common property. No need to write the elements separately. So you have to remember in roster form or tabular form, you have to write all the elements of a set, and in set builder form or property method, you have to write down only the property. Look, A equals to X such that X less equals to 20, X is prime number and X belongs to N. Now, how to get all the elements of this set? First natural number is 1. 1 is neither prime nor composite, so 1 does not belong to A. 2 is prime and which is less than equals to 20. 2 will be an element of A. Similarly, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17 and 19. All the elements are less than 20 and prime number.
Now let us discuss some simple problems.
of representation of set. Here write the following set in roster form. That is, we have to write A, B, C, the sets, as roster form. They are given in set builder form. A equals to x such that x is an integer and restriction of x is minus 3 less equals to x less than 7. So restriction is minus 3 less equals to x less than 7. X is an integer. So which integers belongs to under this restriction? So obviously minus 3, as minus 3 less equals to x. Next minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7? No, because x is less than 7. So they are all integers under this restriction. So the set A will be minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in the form of roster form. Now you may ask me, is it necessary to write all the numbers of the set A in the ascending order? No, because we know that the elements are independent of order. Next, the set B is X, collection of all the elements X such that X is a prime divisor of 60. Now, look, the prime divisor of 60 are, we can divide it by 2, next 3, next 5. So, prime divisor of 60 are 2, 3, 5. Anything else? No. So, the set B can be represented in the roster form like 2, 3, 5. There are only 3 elements. The set C is given as the set of all the letters in the word better. In the word better, the letters are B, E, T, T, E, R. So the letters are B, E, T, T, E and R. So the set C will be B, E, T and R, because all the elements of a set are distinct. So we cannot repeat the letter E twice, as well as we cannot repeat the letter T twice. So the set C will be B, E, T and R. Next, write the following sets in set builder form. Here we have A and B in the form of roster form. So A equals to 3, 6, 9, 12. Look at the set very carefully. The elements of the set A are 3, 6, 9, 12. We can write this set in set builder form in various way. We select one way that we can see that 3, 6, 9 and 12 are all are the multiples of the element 3. So we may write A equals to like x such that x equals to, we can write a as 3x such that x belongs to natural numbers. And here 3x is the form of any element of this set. So x is a natural number, so we can write x belongs to n, and 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9 and 3 4s are 12. So restriction of x is less than 5. Why? If we choose x equals to 1, x is natural number, x equals to 1, then we can get the number 3. If x is 2, then 3 into 2 6. If x is 3, then 3 3s are 9, and if x is 4, 3 4s are 12. So you may write set as A equals to, in second brackets, 3x such that x belongs to natural number set n and x is less than 5. Now for the set B equals to 1, 4, 9, dot 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 up to 100. So you can see that the number started from 1 up to 100. The number started from 1 and end at 100. Which numbers belong to this set B? Look, if we write the numbers as 1 to the power 2, 2 to the power 2, 2 square equals to 4, 3 square is 9, up to 100 will be 10 square. So we get a common property of these elements, that is, the elements are the square of first 10 natural numbers. So we can write B as B equals to x square, such that x is the first 10 naturals, or you may write as the set B equals to x square, such that x belongs to n, set of natural number n, and x is less than 11. So if we choose this first 10 natural or x less than 11, then first natural is 1, 1 square 1, 2, 2 square 4, 3, 3 square 9, up to 10, 10 square 100. So this was the representation of set. I hope you can understand all the discussion. In the next video, we will discuss about the different kind of sets and their definition, their property, and how to use those properties to solve some problems related to sets. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, and comment. And obviously, please do subscribe my channel, Strong Math. Mention your query. Keep watching. Thank you.